Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video's subtotal Excel function, watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Today we have a topic with us is called subtotal in Excel. Now this is basically a math function. Over and all, this function is useful when you have to sum up things. So see, the Microsoft Excel subtotal function is a function which is responsible for returning the subtotal, or basically what we see is aggregate result of all the numbers which are present in a column of a list of a particular data. So the subtotal function is basically a built-in worksheet function for Microsoft Excel, and it is categorized as math and a trig function. So a subtotal Excel function can be entered in a cell of a worksheet as a part of subtotal formula in Excel. Now, the return value of the subtotal function can be result of, any sort of a combined function, like, it can be sum, it can be average function, or probably a count function, max, and so on and so forth, and other which either including or excluding values in the hidden row. Okay, now when I press is equal to and write subtotal here, what do we get? Two things: the function number and ref. So the function number, this is basically the number which specifies which function should be used for a calculation of subtotals within a list, and there is reference number one, reference two, and so on and so forth. So what is that? So ref one, this is a name range, or basically a reference to a subtotal, and the ref two is, this is optional, this is the name range or reference to the subtotal. So there is another thing that's called a return value. Now the return value is will be the numerical value which represents a specific kind of a subtotal. Well, on the usage notes, where exactly this can be used, see, the subtotal function is used to get a subtotal in a list or a database. Now the subtotal can be used for different functions when subtotaling it, which includes you have average, count, max, and others. So all the functions that are there. Now the subtotal function, it basically, you can say it excludes values in the row which is hidden by a filter, and it is default. Fourth, the subtotal function is very useful function in Microsoft Excel. Now, what are the available functions that you have for subtotal? See, as stated, the subtotal function can use different functions when subtotaling. Here, the list of the available functions are too much. Average, count, counter, max, min, product, and sum, and so on and so forth. There is a list of it. But we will start with an example to understand this, we'll understand in a very detailed format. See, as you will see, there is a detail over here of order ID, quantity, unit costs, and total cost. Now, if you look this, you need to look at this here as a part of an example function in Excel. These examples will help you in exploring to use the subtotal function in Excel. Now, based on the above, Excel spreadsheet, let's consider three examples to see the subtotal functions returned based on subtotal formula. Consider this whole table here, and what we are going to do here is that we'll start with subtotal. When we open that, we have to write the function number. So for function number, we'll say 2, comma, the reference 1 will be from D2 to D5, because that is what I want the subtotal of. So it says 4, right? Now if we change it here to 1, it says 81.75. okay, when we change it to 2, it says D2. So let me just keep it over here as 1. It says 81.75. if you change here, instead of 1, if you just change it to 2, you get 4, because there are 4 numbers in total. Now in example number 3 over here, instead of 2, we'll write 3, it will again show us 4 as the answer. Now, on the next part, just write over here, instead of 3, just change it to 4, we get 120 as the answer. Keep changing it. You'll get different answers over there. Change it to 5. It will show us 30. Now, let's change it to 6. And it shows a very big number here. Let's go for 7 now. 38.71. 8. 33.5291. 9. It shows us 327. And over here, 10. It shows us 1498. Similarly, for here, just keep it as 11. So 1124. So see how this formula has been used. Now, if you get any kind of error from the subtotal function in Excel, then it can be any one of the following. The first one is can be a value. These kind of error occurs if the given function or number argument is not one of the permitted values. That is, it is not between what we say 1 and 11, or probably you can say 101 to 111. Second, there's another kind of error that's called div error, div 0. So this error occurs because of the required calculation is involving division by numerical 0. So the required calculation can be anything, like for example, finding the average, standard deviations, or variance of for a range of cells which are not containing any numerical value. A couple of things that you need to remember about this function is that the subtotal function returns the subtotal of the numbers which are present in a column or of a list or a database. So a subtotal function maybe has an ability to return a sum or average or count or max function, and others we either including excluding values hidden rules. So when the value of the function is between, let's say, 1 to 11, the subtotal function will include the hidden values. Now, when the value of the function number is, let's say, between 101 to 111, the subtotal function will exclude or ignore the hidden values. Now, in filtered, the subtotal will always ignore the values which are present in the hidden rows, which is regardless of the function. The subtotal function ignores the subtotal values which already exists in the references. So it is done to prevent the error of double counting. The Excel subtotal function, is designed for calculation of what we call as vertical data value, which is arranged vertically in Excel sheet and in horizontal ranges. So the value in the hidden column will always be included. So if you have liked this video and if you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on the video and subscribe to our channel for latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.